Hello everybody, this is Parveen and I welcome you to the App DNA channel where we talk about all things apps. Today I'll be talking to you how we can build a simple contacts app with our low-code platform Zoho Creator. What is Zoho Creator? Zoho Creator is a new-age low-code builder where we use a drag-and-drop interface to drag elements, drop them, build our workflows, and deploy app quickly. It is targeted for both developers and non-developers. Today in our tutorial, I'll show you how you can build a simple contacts form without the help of any coding. So let's get started with the steps in our contacts app. The basic purpose of a contacts app is to do away with paper and spreadsheets. This contacts app will have five features. The first is that we will create a contacts form in which we will be inputting all the detailed information about our employees or contacts. The second is that we will access the app in the live mode and check how to input information into this form. The third is that we will make this form live so that we can publish the link anywhere in our Facebook or social media profiles and ask our contacts to put their information themselves. The fourth is that I'll share the app with our employees so that they can edit their information themselves. And in the fifth, the employee would be able to check their reports where they can find their information. So let's get started with each of these features step by step. We will now log into creator.zoho.com where I'll be building the first form, and that is the add contacts. Welcome to creator.zoho.com where we will be building our contacts app. If you have already been maintaining spreadsheets for your contacts, then you can simply import those files with this import a file feature, and an app will be created automatically for you by Creator. I'll go for a new application, and this will land me up in the app gallery where we have 50 pre-made applications built for you. At the end of the tutorial, I will be installing the contacts app, which is one among these apps, and we will see it later on. But for now, we will get started from scratch. I'll name it as Contacts 2018. And this lands me in this edit workspace where we'll be creating our forms, our workflows, our settings. Creator has so many modules that we have designed separately. We have our workflows and settings. I'll create a new form and I will name it as my contacts form. Now, how can we create our form? We can either create it from blank. We can import our data if we have been using separate Excels. We can use one of the business templates that we have, of which contacts is also one. Or we can integrate with our existing apps. I'll go for a blank form and I'll name it as new contact. This is our form builder where we will be dragging and dropping this data fields that we have, and we will create our form one by one. So for my contacts, first I want to have their personal information. I will go down and drag this section form here. This section field will create separate sections for my contact. So I'll name this section as personal information. Once I know the section, I want to know the name of my contact. Next, I want to know their email. I want to know their address. So I just have to simply drag and drop these elements here. Once I know their name, email, address, and phone number, I want to know their birthday. For this, I can use the date field here and name it as birthday. Date of birth. Next, I can use an image field for their picture. And now I will have another section, and that would be about their professional information. I'll name this section as work information. And in work information, I would like to know their company name. For this, I will use the single line field here, which is used for single lines of information. The name is it as company information. Then their department. For this, I'll use single line field again. A separate section was created for this. I have to delete it. This single line would be named for. Then I want to know their designation, their company address. For this, I can use either the multi-line field or I can use the address field again. This one I'll name as company address. Once the work information is done, now I will use a subform. A subform is a form within a form. And let's see how subforms work in Creator. So I'll name this subform as social media profiles. So I want to know the social media profiles of my contact. You haven't created any field yet. So I'll add my fields here. I'll use a single line field. And then I'll use a drop down here. So in my drop down, I will type the platform. Say it's a social network, and I'll have the choices. Twitter, and I'll allow other choices. And I'll name the single line field as
links. So my social network they'll choose and they will type the links. Now that the social media profiles are done, let me see if I have missed out on any important contact information. Yeah, I didn't have gender, so I'll use a radio button right here below the name and I'll use it for their gender. Gender I can have male, female, others. And then I want to use a drop down field for their hobbies. In hobbies, I can have traveling, reading, cooking. Reading is my hobby. And yeah, what all hobbies they can have. Painting. And then I'll allow for other choices to allow for diverse range of hobbies. And then you can have a lot of other stuff. Let's say they can have multi-line fields here for their favorite codes. So you can make your contact information as expansive as you want. You can have some more notes here if you want to jot down any particular things about them. So after all this, my contacts is very comprehensive. I've added as much as I could. Let's hit done. And now I will go on to access this application. The moment I access this application, I'll be entering the live mode of our app where we will see our app running. So this is my new contact. You see how pretty it looks. I have the personal information of any of my contact. I have their work information and I have their hobbies and favorite codes and stuff. So this sections just look bad because they are just section. I'm going to edit the application and make it look much better. So anytime you want to edit your application, you go to the edit mode. You go and open the form builder and you make any of the modifications that you want. So let's see what modifications do we want. Yeah, here in our work information, it's still single line. I had changed it to company name. Let's see if it's working this time. Department, designation. The address is working fine. The social media profiles are fine. I'll change the section as interests, personality. And here it would be extra. And the multi-line field name was notes. Now hit done. And again, we'll go and access our application. This time, it looks much better with our social media profiles, our interests, personality, and extras. Let's get started with.
Now that we have built the form, let's access in the live mode and check how the reports look once we have submitted the information of a contact.
Now that our form is live, let's get started with the first contact. Let's say it's me. I fill up my details for the ad search on the map. My social media profiles. So here I can choose Instagram. So this is how the subform works. Add new, and here you can choose, let's say, Facebook. And then I add new, and here again I choose Twitter. Next, in my hobbies, I like traveling. I can add more. I like reading, favorite cards, rage against the dying of the light, and in notes, you can type anything. Let's say you can type the languages I know, whatever, and hit submit. So every time you submit a form and creator, each of these get recorded in a separate report. So in my all new contacts, you can check my details right here. If you want to see them in detail, you can click like this. You can see my image. I'm a pasta, and you can see all the information about me. Now we will go back to our edit mode, and we will rename this report. We will make it look better. So I go to my all new contacts, I open the report properties, and here I can rename it. So I'll rename it as just all contacts instead of all new contacts. Here you can use grouping, sorting, quick filters. You can sort based on the name. You can sort them in ascending order. So all the A's come first and then the B's. Hit done. And then when you go and reload the app, your report name has changed. And because there are no more data, the sorting is not working. But this is how the form looks. And we will now move on to the next feature.
In the third feature, we will be publishing the form so that people who do not have a login user ID need not log into Creator to access the form. This form would be publicly available to everyone who can access the link.
Now that our contacts form is done, I will show you how we can publish it and make it live. Publishing a form means that you do not need a login. Anyone who has the link can access this form. And this will be very useful if you want to publish your contacts form in your websites or in your Facebook profiles, anywhere. So first up, what we do is we go to settings. Here we go to users and controls and publish. Here, you haven't published anything yet. Yes, I want to publish my new contact. As soon as you hit publishing, it will take you here and you can copy to clipboard this link. This shows that this form has been published. Now you go to your browser, paste the link. And you'll see how beautifully this is the published form. You do not need a link to this. I mean, you do not need a login for this. You do not need to have access to Creator app. You can simply access this link anywhere and this form would open up for you. So if you publish it and paste the link in your Facebook or in your websites, this would appear right away and it would also get saved in the reports. So this is how publishing works in Creator.
Now, if I'm using this contacts app for my organization, I'll show you how you can share the app with your employees so that they can edit their information themselves.
Now that I have shown you how to access this form without having a login, how to publish, you might be wondering, how do you access it with a login? What happens when you are an employee of the organization and you need access to this app and check out your personal details? For that, we have this sharing button right here in the green. So you click here and you create share application with a user, a customer, or a developer. Your employees are your users, so you hit here. Now add a user. Let's say my friend Akshay is a user. Choose a permission, read, write, or a permission set. I would give him a permission set. I will create a new profile for him and I'll name it as employee. Here I'll give him access to the new contact form so that he can add his form and view to all contacts so that he can check all the employees' details. If you don't want him to have an access to all contacts, you can create a separate report where he will be filtered using his login user ID and then you can share that with him. I will share all the contacts, share, and now we will see how sharing works. We will go to Akshay's mail. He should have received right here, he got the mail. Parveen has invited you to access the Contact 2018 app. Go to the application and right here you see that Akshay has also got access to the app. So this is how sharing works in Creator. He can add his details, all sorts of stuff, and submit. Now in all contacts, Akshay gets added right here. And because I've sorted it in ascending order, Akshay is put on the top. So this is how sharing an app in Creator works.
In the fifth feature, I'll show you how to create reports. We will create an employee report where the employee can view their information exclusively.
Now that we have shared the app with our employees, we will look at how to create a report just for our employees with their filtered login user ID. So I want the type of report to be list based on the form new contact. I'll name my report as my information. This is exclusively for my employees. When they log in, they can see only their information there and they can edit it. This one, I'll open report properties and I'll add a filter. The filter is that the email should equal Zoho login user ID. Hit save and done. Now when I go and reload my app, I'll see that my information is right here. And because I'm logged in with my user ID parveen.c, I can see only my information here and I can edit it. In all contacts, I can see both Akshay and Parveen, but in my information, I can see only myself. So next time when I'm adding an employee and sharing them a profile, then I can choose to have only my information access to be given to them. This is how reports work in Creator. You can have a host of other reports with a lot of filters and sorting and stuff.
Let's have a quick recap of the Contacts app.
We will quickly recap the Contact app that we did now. First up, we created this entire form with sections, subforms and stuff. And then we added the information. All the information we could see in our all contacts. Then we managed to publish this form and make it public. Then we shared the app with our employees. And finally, we made a report where the employees can check only their information.
I'll now take you to the app gallery where we will create a new application and show how this Contacts app is available as a template in Creator. You simply have to drag and drop the template and it can be integrated as a base for your other bigger apps.
I'll now show you how you can use this contact app simply as a template when you create a new application. So let's create a new application, create from scratch, and I'll name it as hit create. And this time when you're creating a new form, instead of blank, go to from a template. And here you have a host of form templates. So many of them are here. We have appointment booking, cab booking, conference booking, and one of these is the contact. Where is it? So you have your employee details right here. You can use this template. You have your machine category, your order management, your personal. So contacts is here. You use the template, create it, and right here when you access the application now, your contact template is ready. So you just had to use the template, and now on top of that, you can use your other forms and workflows and build vast, huge systems like HRMS, your human resource systems, your administration systems, your lead management, sales management, most specifically your CRM. So the contact is the basic template that you can use. So you have your birthdays, email IDs, all the things that I did in the tutorial. Only you needed to drag and drop the template here. Or you can install the contact app from the app gallery. So this easy.
You can stash your paper right away and start using our contacts app. If you have any doubts, then shoot them below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such app making videos. Till then, keep making apps and be happy.